safe?
I'll let you be the judge of that. Bring it out, Brian.
Well, let me start by saying welcome. In fact, after reading your training reports, I think you'll all do very well.
Connors is giving you a hard time and you want me to do something about it. Is that correct?
It's more than just a hard time. You know what they did to my house. And then she tried to kill me. Of course, if I try to retaliate, her bikey friends will... Well, that's where I'm asking for your help. I'd appreciate it if you'd get them off my back.
Who are they?
The Conquerors.
I've been on my own for a long time. And then suddenly you came along and it was great. I had someone to talk to, someone to...
Andrew.
Look. So if you come home in a bad mood, okay, I'll do what I did tonight.
Andrew, please.
Don't move out, Joan. We make a good pair. Don't we?
If any of your mates turn up, you can duck behind the door. They never look there.
What if they see me?
Then we will be in the pound, and you'll get kicked out of the service. So you better stay behind the door, eh?
Andrew, I'm sorry. I don't want to hurt your feelings.
My feelings can look after themselves. But I know... Well, I feel that you like me.
Of course I do. But I've told you before, I'm not looking for anything other than friendship.
But I just want us to be special friends, and we're that already, aren't we?
Not in the way you mean. Andrew, I've enjoyed your company, and I owe you so much for letting me stay here.
Not letting you. Wanting you to. You brought something back into my life.
Andrew, I'm not right for you. You hardly know me.
But it doesn't take long for people to know if they really like each other.
I told you before. I had a bad experience and... Well, it'll be a long time before I'm ready for another relationship.
Yes, well, that is exactly what you should be doing. If you close yourself off from people, you'll never get over it. I know, because that's what I did.
If you'd been through what Terry put me through, you'd understand.
Joan, I do understand. Look, I don't know what this Terry did to you, but I am not him.
Terry... No, it doesn't matter. Andrew, you're one of the kindest people I've ever met. And a good friend. Can't we just leave it at that?
Yes. Yes, of course, I shouldn't have brought it up in the first place.
I'd like to be what you want me to be, Andrew, but... I'm sorry, I can't.
Boo! Hiss! She don't look mean enough to be the freak. She needs her hair chopped or something.
And give her a lemon to suck on.
Oh, cut! This is recording sound, too, if you don't mind. The only person not making any noise is Lorelai.
Well, what am I supposed to say? I'm the only one here, aren't I?
Well, you could do an evil laugh or something.
You could freak and drool over it, for sure. Oh, great, I love it.
At last I found the good witch's Nancy's book of evil spells, and with it I can rule the world!
Yes, that's good. Now, first position, and we'll try one.
We'll try what?
You know, shoot the scene.
Oh. Then why didn't you say so, Nance? For God's sake, talk English.
It's how they talk in the movies.
And how would you know?
Come on, let's get a move on. Our pin-up boy might be taking second thoughts.
Yeah, that's right, let's do it.
Oh, no, hang on.
Action. Cut. Okay, next scene.
But what about my speech? I mean, the one about the magic spell.
Oh, no, it works very well without it, Lorelai, trust me. Now, the next scene is the rec room, and you have to take that uniform off and put it back on again when we get there.
How's it looking, Lurch?
Well, coast clear.
Oh, God, if they catch us, they'll feed us to the trolls for sure.
Oh, we won't get caught, even if we did, to be worth it. I haven't had this much fun in ages, eh?
Oh, that hedgehog man, crawl back into your hole.
hole before I kick your brains out. Oh, no, you don't. You can't get away that easy. Come back here.
Oh, what you doing?
Very funny.
You're playing a game, aren't you? Just like Julie Egbert the day she got married. She was running around in a nutty too.
You just tell your friends they better get my uniform back damn quick or I'll forget about how it looks and go ahead and report them.
Same thing happened to Captain Marvelous once. He was caught in the end.
Just get out of here.
Okay.
Steady on, Jones. Now, you ought to save your energy for exercise period tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm sorry, miss. I was just keeping the world safe from the hedgehog monster till Captain Adams got his space suit back.
Well, I'm sure the world can survive. Now, you get a move on and watch where you're going.
Captain Adams?
Rodney should feel honoured. I think Mel's got her comic book heroes all mixed up.
She must get a lot of ribbing from the others about it.
No, not to her face. I think they've got more sense than that.
Oh, yeah, see what you mean. She even makes me look small.
Well, the others must be in the rec room. Let's go and see if they're behaving.
Swine hunts! You will pay for making a fool of me. You will all be killed and then tortured.
Excuse me, miss. Don't you mean tortured, then killed?
You know what I mean. Think hell!
Freak hell! Freak hell! Freak hell!
Oh, yes, yes, that's very good. Can you two stand a bit closer together? Right, we'll do it.
Probably be just like this when she gets back here tomorrow.
No way. Why do you think she's been away from us all afternoon? We made her look like a bloody fool and there's nothing she can do about it.
Bit risky pushing her too far.
Come on, everybody. Quiet now. And action.
Oh, no, I forgot my line.
Don't tell me to be bloody quiet. It's a free country.
Shut up, Williams.
Yeah, sure.
Well, a bit of background noise doesn't matter. It's good atmosphere.
Yeah, well, I can't think of me lines with all this noise going on.
Jeez, screws are coming.
Bloody hell.
Let's see you get out of this one.
No time. Hide. We're here.
Anywhere.
In here.
What will you do with the camera?
Just act naturally.
One word out of you and you're dead. You ready, Nance?
And action.
Oh, g'day, Mrs. Morris.
What's going on?
Oh, we're just having some fun with the video gear.
Yeah, it's a scream when you play it backwards.
Well, I hope you're looking after the camera now that Mr. and Mrs. Pringle aren't here to keep an eye on you.
I didn't know the department supplied cameras.
They don't. It's on loan from a friend of the Pringles.
Generous?
I think it's an arrangement that suits everyone.
Oh, it looks complicated. How long does it take to learn how to work it?
Oh, not long. I've been reading books.
Well, don't stop on our account.
We were just about finished anyway, Mrs. Morris.
Yeah, we don't want to use up all our tape at once.
Well, there'd hardly be enough light in here, would there?
Oh, yes, the camera's very sensitive.
You have sound as well?
Mm, that microphone picks everything up.
Can't wait to see the finished product.
Geez, I wish you'd use your hanky, Lurch.
Oh, yeah. Oh, sorry, hay fever.
You see, Mrs. Morris, that's all part of the scene. Lorelei's in there. We're doing our version of the Diary of Anne Frank. You see, there was this girl and she had to hide in the attic.
Yes,
when the Germans
I know who Anne Frank was.
Yeah, well, we're doing the bit where she jumps out of the storeroom and escapes.
Yes. Well, I don't remember that bit. Let's have a look for myself. Wilkinson, come out of there.
Isn't that funny? Version of the film I saw, The Star Wore Clothes.
We can't explain, Mrs. M.
Good.
Well, you see, Mrs. Morrissey, I was giving Top Dog an allergic cheek, so they took all my clothes off and put me in the cupboard. Look, no harm was meant, really.
Yeah, that's the truth, Mrs. Morris. Come on, Lurch. Give Laurie your clothes back.
Huh?
Oh, sure.
Thank you.
Well, I think we'll have a little less messing around in future, don't you? Especially with that expensive camera in here.
Oh, it won't happen again, Mrs. Morris. I'll see to it.
Glad to hear it. Well, are you going to stand there all night, or are you going to put your clothes on, Wilkinson?
Oh.
Here we are. Sorry about that, got a bit crunched, but you can thank Mrs. M and Miss Stout for that. I would have ironed them for you, but the laundry's shut today.
Yeah, you won't put anything like this over me again. You can rest assured on that. You've made yourself a bad enemy.
Oh,
Oh, you want to watch who you're threatening, Junior. This little story could still get out, you know.
Oh, yeah? I've got my uniform back now. It's your word against mine. You think they'll believe you?
I reckon they might. Come to the crunch, we got the proof on tape. So you want to watch it. Well, the next time I might take your jocks too.
That'll really give the girls a laugh.
Jeez, I thought we were all done for when Mrs. M opened that door.
5 seconds early we would have been. I felt like Houdini in there.
Well, we've got two more scenes to shoot and the sooner we finish.
You should have seen him. What a jerk. Stuck behind the door, red as a bloody beetroot.
Yeah, real wimp.
You don't think he'll make any trouble?
Nah, he'd probably die if anyone found out.
Yeah, I wish they'd send us a few more like that. We'd be running the joint in no time.
Yeah, we don't want to take him too lightly, all the same.
What do you mean?
Well, he's such a suck. Mug like that could get to be a real pain if we give him half a chance.
Oh, come on, Reet. We were in rings around him this morning.
Yeah, and that's how we're going to keep it. That way, he'll be so busy trying to hang on to his job, he won't have any time to make any trouble for us.
Oh, Rita, he's only a boy. Don't think he means any harm.
Don't worry, Nance. All we're going to do is make his life a bit more interesting.
Yeah, take him down a peg or two.
I thought you had the hots for him.
Nah, not him. Mr. Jackson's a spunk.
Hey, Laurie, will you do me makeup in the morning?
Of course.
Oh, bloody hell, here we go, lusting time again.
Whatever it is, we don't want any. Rack off.
Are you in charge?
I said rack off, mate. No one comes here without an invitation.
Got my card right here.
Oh, very nice. Do you know which end goes bang?
McDermott's my name. A lot of your blokes will know me. I've done deals with them before.
Said we don't want any. We get it wholesale.
Tonight I'm not selling. Tonight I'm talking about Rita Connors and her little brother. Unless you're even stupider than you look, you'll listen real carefully.
I hope you're not feeling pressured. I mean, please don't rush into buying a house because of what I said. You're more than welcome to stay here as long as you like as a friend.
Oh, it's not that, Andrew. It's basically, I'm a private person. I need a place of my own.
Yeah, well, that's understandable. I hope you won't be too private.
How do you mean?
Well, I just hope we can still be friends.
Oh, of course we can. There aren't too many people I can say that about. Oh, we can have dinner sometimes and dig up the fairways together.
As often as you like. Look, I'm sorry if I've been a bit, I've had very little to do with women since my wife died.
You'll meet someone, Andrew.
But it's difficult to meet people who measure up, you know? I mean, Mary was quite a woman. She had this special inner strength. You remind me of her in lots of ways. Hello.
Yeah.
Just a minute. It's for you.
Thanks. Yes?
I've taken care of that little matter for you.
Uh-huh. You sure it's completely settled?
Oh, yes. Morgan's been over to have a word to the Conquerors. He made it very clear. Any misbehaviour on their part, it'll go very badly for the Connors boy and his friend.
All very well, as long as they believed him.
Oh, they believed him. One word from me, both those kids are dead.
Yes, I'm sure my friends must have been pleased.
I understand someone's going over to Wentworth in the morning to explain things to Connors.
Good, but I'd like to break that news to him myself.
Of course.
Yes, well, I appreciate your help.
Don't mention it. Always glad to do the right thing by a friend. Bye for now.
Yes. There was someone from work.
Oh, everything all right?
Yes, fine. Couldn't be better.
I think we can say our fish is nicely hooked.
So when do we pull her in?
When I'm ready, Morgan. When I'm ready.
So, was it better or worse than you expected?
Yes.
Well, I don't see any problems at all. It's just a matter of staying sharp and watching out for things like fake bombs.
That doesn't go on every day, does it?
No.
Well, if it happens again, we'll certainly be ready. At least I will. First day is one thing, but we can't expect the department to keep making allowances.
Oh, I'm sure they won't need to. I think you all cope very well under the circumstances.
Wow, we must have done all right. I can say from a lifetime of experience, my mother doesn't hand out praises lightly.
Very wise. He's got enough ego as it is.
Go ahead. Gang up on me, why don't you?
It's just a little constructive criticism, Marty. There's no need to lose your sense of humour.
Thanks, mate. I'll try not to.
Well, I must say the staff seem like a pleasant lot. Yourself included, of course, Mrs. Morris. I'm sure I'll get along well with them all.
Yes, everyone was very helpful. I hardly felt like a stranger at all.
And you didn't even have a mother to hold your hand either.
No, though, I could almost feel Dad breathing down my neck. He was an officer at Pentridge till he retired.
I didn't know that. How did he feel about you coming into the service?
Well, he went to great pains to tell me what a hard grind it was going to be and that I must be out of my mind to take it on. But I think he's kind of proud I did.
I'm sure he is. And what about you, Rod? Are you following in any family footsteps?
Nope. All my own idea. Well, Dad's in the public service. Very big on career prospects. He's convinced I'll end up governor.
Stranger things have happened.
Funny how you change, though. When I was a kid, all I wanted to be was a ballet dancer. Till I did my ankle in and had to give it up. I studied it for years, though.
I wouldn't tell the women that if I were you. You'll never hear the end of it.
Well, it doesn't worry me. I mean, the kids at school were always slinging off at me, but you know what they say, sticks and stones.
Well, kids at school are one thing, but our ladies... My advice to you is not to give them any ammunition at all.
Understood. But I don't see this as any form of ammunition. And I don't see how the issue would ever come up, but if it did, I see no reason to evade it. There's only one way to deal with them. It's to let them know you don't care what they think.
Well, that's one way of looking at it.
Oh, I respect your right to a different opinion, of course. Well, I've enjoyed everyone's company, but I must rush. See you tomorrow.
Look forward to it.
No, Rod.
Now you've had the real expert's opinion.
He'll learn.
I'd bet on it.
Marty, I thought I'd brought you up better than that.
Sorry.
Cheer up, Nance. Time will go real quick, you'll see.
Yeah, the girlfriend will understand.
Oh, no, I'm not thinking about that. I'm just worried about Roach. Since yesterday, she's done nothing but sit in her cell and sulk.
It's her business, isn't it?
Oh, not quite, Rita. Admitted, everyone's treating her like an enemy.
As long as she keeps doing business with Maxwell and Williams, that's exactly what she needs.
Anyone wants to be in the gang, they stick to the rules.
Oh, come off it. Ain't you ever seen anyone wearing makeup?
Could have fooled us. Looks more like it's wearing you, eh?
All right, that's enough. Settle down. Don't take any notice of them, Jenkins. They're just jealous.
Oh, yeah. Thanks. Reckon they are.
We're flavour of the month, eh?
New face on the block, that's all. In a couple of days, she'll forget I'm even here.
Reckon?
What's that mean?
Looks a bit starry-eyed, if you ask me.
They're just having some fun. Don't you think I can tell when a woman's serious about me?
Oh, in a flash, I'm sure.
Look at her.
What?
The way she's looking at him. Reckon she's got him all sewn up, I'll bet.
Oh, Alice, I'm sure they're just good friends.
Oh, no, not the way she threw that medicine ball at me. Flapping her eyelashes at him. Hasn't she got any pride?
Good morning. Trust we'll be more alert today, I hope.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Good.
Good morning, Miss Ferguson. Looks like being another nice day.
Does it, Connors? You better be careful of that plate. Now, Connors, that was deliberate. In fact, you can clean it up right now and stay on cleaning duties for the rest of the day. Williams can take over the press.
She thinks she's playing at.
I don't know, do I?
I knew we were pushing her too far.
That's not it. The bitch has got something on her sleeve.
Yeah, well, we better find out what it is.
Oh, well, all right.
You don't need to bite my bloody head off.
I thought Miss Ferguson told you to clean that up.
Yeah.
Whatever happened to Sir?
Yes, Sir.
Okay, now get on with it.
Looks like there's been a change in the ground rules.
Yeah, I wonder what.
I'll have to wait and ask Miss Ferguson. I'm sure she'll be delighted to tell us.
Morning, Mrs. Reynolds. You're in bright and early.
Morning. Morning, Beth.
Oh, I know I'm supposed to search everything that comes in, but I guess we can trust you not to smuggle
you
any...
You search everything, Mr. Adams. You regard no one as above suspicion.
Of course. Certainly. Oh, Mrs. Reynolds, I was thinking last night, and if it's all right with you, of course, that I could take the women for aerobics a couple of times a week during the exercise period.
Aerobics?
Oh, yes, I'm a bit of a fitness freak, and I put a lot of stock in organized group exercise. There are great things to be said for it.
I'm sure there are, but I'm not sure...
Well, firstly, it'll improve fitness levels. Secondly, it's a great way to reinforce a sense of discipline. And thirdly, well, it's a way to keep them occupied. Yes. Out of mischief, if you know what I mean.
I suppose it could do some good if you're prepared to take it on and if the women are interested.
Well, definitely. All part of the job as far as I'm concerned.
I'll put it to them and see what sort of reaction we get.
Great.
Thank you.
Hello,
Meg. Good morning. What did Marty think of his first day?
Well, couldn't be too bad. He's coming back for more this morning.
Good. Would you ask Joan to come to my office after muster?
Well, what's the problem? Or shouldn't I ask?
Just want to re-emphasize, no paybacks over that bomb hoax.
Uh-huh. I'll tell her.
Thanks.
What do you think you're doing? Get out of my way.
So, you think you can run the press, do you?
Wasn't my idea.
People who don't know what they're doing can have nasty accidents.
You try anything and you'll all end up at Blackmore.
Didn't say we'd do anything. Just thought you might have an accident.
You lot don't scare me. Get out of the way.
What's going on?
Ah, oh, nothing, Mrs. M. Just girl talk.
You saved that for recreation period. Go on, get a move on.
Oh, excuse me, Mrs. Morris. I was wondering, did Mrs. Reynolds mention to you anything about my videotape, whether I could send it or not? You know, the one of me giving bedtime stories to my little girl?
No, not to me, but I'll remind her of it.
Thank you very much. I'd appreciate it.
What are you doing?
I'm moving this video to a better hiding place. If any of the officers see that uniform, we'll all end up in trouble.
Yeah, that'd really make them lose their sense of humour, eh?
Yes, and I can't risk having my visiting privileges suspended for another 2 weeks.
Oh, you wouldn't be that unlucky.
Can you imagine how Peter must feel? First having to tell his fiancée his mother's in prison, and then he can't even bring her in to meet me because I'm in more trouble.
Oh, come on, Nancy's your son. He loves you. And I reckon a girl must love him, otherwise they wouldn't be getting engaged. You'll get to meet her soon enough, and I bet you get on like a house on fire.
Oh, I hope so, for Peter's sake.
Make yourself scarce, McCormick.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Pity about the uniform. But that was just the beginning. Now you've had your fun, and you're going to pay for it.
I'd watch it, Ferguson. I got friends, remember?
Yeah. About those friends, Connors. I've got bad news for you.
Who are you kidding? You haven't got that sort of clout, not at Woodridge.
You think I'm bluffing? Go ahead and try me.
I will, don't worry.
Everything I've said to you will be confirmed by one of your friends. So, one step out of line, and your brother is dead.
Bull!
I'd also keep a pretty close watch on the gang in here, too. Because the same applies to Patterson, Jenkins, and McCormick.
You're wasting your time.
And I would also forget about trying to get transferred, Connors. Because I'm going to keep you here, where I can look after you.
You're bluffing. And I'm going to get you for this morning. You can count on it.
I think you'll be glad you didn't have any breakfast.
Oh! I'm not going to forget that.
Good. It might remind you who's in charge around here.
All right, hurry along, everybody. Muster in 5 minutes.
What happened? Oh, the bitch is back to her old form. She punched me one.
Oh, but I thought you had her scared off.
So did I. She must have some real bloody heavy on her side.
Connors was at fault, and I'd like to hear anyone say differently.
Well, from what I saw, Miss Ferguson, I don't think it was deliberate.
You don't? Perhaps you'd like to make out a report to the governor, accusing the deputy governor of harassing a prisoner.
All I'm saying
is... It's all right, Marty. Neither can... Oh.
Connors, cleaning. Williams, laundry. Right, hurry up, ladies.
Hey, just think, me on the press. I'm going to have a ball with those bitches.
I'd just like to know what it is the freak's holding over.
Shows you what she thinks of you. Doesn't tell you anything.
Well, she hasn't had a chance, has she? As soon as everyone's back at work and we can talk, she'll tell me.
I reckon she's got to be bluffing. Who she'd know? Woodridge, who'd kill someone for her.
Yeah, maybe she's lying, maybe she's not. I'm supposed to hear something from the gang today.
Well, if it's true, we're in for a lot of trouble, aren't we?
Yeah, things could get a bit rough.
Well, just watch it. Connors is on cleaning. All we need is for her to see you and the freak with your heads together.
Okay, everyone, attention.
Hey, look who's running the show, but it's okay. Mum's here to hold his hand.
Quiet, Patterson. Officer Morris is worried you lot will be a bad influence on me. She's probably right.
What have you got to be so perky about?
Nothing. I just don't want the freak knowing she's getting to us.
Oh, yeah.
Before we get to duty allocations, I've got an announcement to make. Officer Adams is prepared to conduct aerobics classes, if anyone's interested.
Aerobics?
We'll get names from those who are at lunchtime.
Do you know, aerobics? You've got to be joking.
You should be good for a laugh anyway.
All right, everyone, listen. Duty allocations as follows.
Yes, can we help you?
Yeah, I want to see Reed Connors.
I'm afraid it's not that simple. There are specified times, you know.
Where does it say that?
In the book.
Yeah? Well, no one told me about your book and I'm here now.
Well, I'm sorry, you'll have to wait. I'll come back later.
When are these visiting hours?
I'll have to look them up in the book.
They can't matter too bloody much if you have to look them up in a book. I'm starting to lose my temper. How long am I supposed to wait?
I told you, I'll look them up. Do you mind?
I want to see her now.
What's going on here? Would you mind standing back from the desk, please? Now, what's this all about?
I want to see someone.
I told her she has to wait.
I'm in a hurry.
Who do you want to see?
I told him. Rita Connors.
And your name?
Fleming. Margie Fleming.
Would you mind taking a seat over there, please? And I'll see what can be arranged.
How long am I supposed to wait?
Visiting a prisoner is a privilege, not a right. If there's any more trouble, you won't get in at all. Now, would you mind just taking a seat, please? Didn't handle that very well, did you?
I did the same thing you did. I asked her to wait.
Yeah, well, next time you might try doing it a bit more tactfully. I suggest you read the bit in the manual where it says about dealing with the public. We don't want to have any more unpleasantness than we have to, do we?
No, you're right, of course. Sorry.
Where are you going?
Oh, to get my manual.
I think that can wait until morning tea time. Common sense should see you through till then.
Right, that's it. Everyone to work.
Make sure you give it to Williams.
Yeah. Teach her to crow it over us like that.
Don't worry. We'll give her heaps.
What about the aerobic class? I'm putting my name down for it.
Oh, are you kidding? Jumping around like a bunch of nongs with that jerk perving at us?
By the guide side, which grass seeds come up?
No, you don't. We're going to that class, all of us.
Oh, come on, Ruth, be serious. What are they all for?
Because the kid's going to be taking it. We'll get a chance to get at him again.
Come on, you lot, you heard the order. Get a move on.
Anyway, give us something else to think about besides the freak. She might have got us sweating, but we don't have to let her know it.
Well, things went pretty smoothly for your first attempt.
Yeah, I guess.
And you handled it well when Patterson made that crack about me. I mean, if you let it get to you, that'd have given you a lot more.
I have a feeling Joan Ferguson lied about what happened at breakfast. She was the one who tipped the plate, not Connors.
Did you see it?
Well, she was standing between us and Connors, so I didn't get a clear look, but I'm sure that's what happened.
Hmm. Oh, I don't doubt you. But as you actually can't swear to it, I think you'd better let it drop. But thanks for the moral backup. Now, don't be too quick to pick a fight with Ferguson. She's a bad enemy.
I've got eyes, man.
Is there a problem, Jenkins?
Oh, no, Mrs. M. Real beaut, master.
Well, you've made an impression in one quarter anyway.
Don't you start. It's nothing. The girl's just been friendly, all right?
What do you think Miss Ferguson meant about Rita having a visit?
Yeah, well, 5 will get you 10-1. It's the Conquerors with bad news. Mm.
I know you don't believe me, but the Joan Ferguson I knew was strict but fair.
Oh, yeah.
I look, something's changed, and it is awful. Especially when you're on the receiving end.
Roach, this is no good, you know, this barrier between us. We're your friends.
Well, you could have fooled me.
Oh, we are. You know it.
Sure.
Please, won't you talk to Rita?
Why should I?
Well, you can't really expect her to make the first move when she sees you being so friendly with Kath Maxwell.
I wasn't being friendly. Look, I don't like her or her mates any more than you do.
Well, there you are, you see. We're on the same side. If you and Rita would just talk, it'd all be straightened out in a minute.
It'd be a waste of time.
Oh, please. Won't you try? Can't lose anything. You know, you're letting pride get in the way of friendship, you and Rita both.
Maybe she should get off her high horse for once.
She would if you just tell her you'll have nothing more to do with those two or their drugs.
Oh, don't start on about the coke again.
It's bad for you, Roach. That's been proved.
You don't know anything about it. All you want is to stop anyone else having a bit of fun. You and Rita, you're both as bad as each other.
Well, get out of the way. Freak will be around any minute. And she'll have the lot of you if I'm not on the press.
What's stopping you?
Yeah, go ahead. Do what you like. But don't blame us if they find you with your hands all flattened and crunched.
Oh, yeah. You remember the last accident in any Lurch?
Yeah. They reckon steam hurts the worst. Go on. It's all yours.
McDermott? He works for Parker, doesn't he?
Uh-huh.
Bloody hell, that's bad. He's got the clout to wipe Bongo out and not even think twice about it.
That's what the guys reckon.
Why would Parker want to help the freak? Unless they're behind bringing the drugs in here. And the freak's been helping him.
Everyone knows that's the best way to get stuff in. Have a screw do it for you.
That's gotta be it. And there's gotta be a way for us to use it.
Up to you, Red. It's your party now.
Yeah, there's no way the gang can help, not the way things stand.
Didn't say that.
What do you mean?
No bastard pushes the conquerors around, you know that. Not even McDermott. The guards have got it figured out.
Well, what about Bongo and Grub?
They'll be all right. We got a plan, see? You'll have to sit still and cop it for the time being. But once we get things set, then the Ferguson bitch is really gonna get what's coming to her.
Details don't concern you. All you need to know is that as of last night, I've got Connors exactly where I want her.
Congratulations, but where does that leave me?
You're not listening, Maxwell. Now we make our move against Connors, and there isn't a thing that she can do about it.
We?
That was the deal. With the governor breathing down my neck, I have to be careful.
Well, just remember, you're part of the deal. I need more drugs now. Otherwise, I'll lose the swingers.
Well, you'll have them soon. After we fix Connors, the rest of the warriors will be easy pickings.
You got a plan for Connors?
Yes. As soon as you can fix it, I want an all-out fight between Connors and Jones.
Jones, what have you got on?
It's my new cosmic uniform. Don't you reckon it's lovely?
It's absurd, and it's not uniform. Get rid of it.
No.
Don't argue. Get rid of it or I'll take it from you.
I had Jones transferred from C Block to be your muscle.
I don't want to use her like that. She's just an overgrown kid, that's all. If people would just leave her alone, she wouldn't be a problem.
I don't care what sort of a problem she is, as long as she takes care of Connors.
Well, I do. You heard what the governor said. Any more trouble from her and she'll be sent to an institution.
I think you'd better get your priorities right, Maxwell.
I can't help feeling sorry for her.
Right. Just this once, I will guarantee she won't be sent to an institution.
How can you do that?
I'm fast losing my patience with you, Maxwell. Now, you need me more than I need you, so you'd better make up your mind. Quickly!
It's mine! Get her back to me! No, you're a bad man! You're a bad
man! Let me go, you hear me? Let me go!
Stop it! Now, you stop it, please. You're hurting Mr. Adams. You don't want to hurt anybody, do you?
He's got my horse here. Give him back to me.
It's broken. It's broke. You hurt my horse.
Now, listen to me. We can fix the horse. I'll fix it for you.
But he broke it.
Get away from him!
Remember what Mrs. Reynolds said? If you were naughty again, you'd have to go away to that bad place.
I wasn't naughty. I didn't hurt him. I just wanted my horsey back.
Now, you've got your horsey back. We'll go and fix him now, all right?
Why did you break my horsey?
He didn't mean it, and he's very sorry, really.
What happened?
She's a
watch it.
She nearly killed me.
I think you're overreacting. Trainees usually do the first time. Now, what really happened?
I simply asked her to give me that stuff she's wearing, and when I took it off, she attacked me. She ought to be locked up.
She is.
I mean, put away.
It's all a noise.
Nothing serious. Everything's under control.
Nothing serious.
We don't need any help. Carry on, Mr. Jackson.
Right.
Now, James.
Don't go, my horsey. Please, he's my friend.
No. I won't take your horsey. Nor any of your other things. But you mustn't wear them at work, right? You must keep them in your cell.
Can I?
Yes, of course you can. But you must promise me you'll behave yourself from now on.
Yeah, I will. I will, I promise.
Good, good. Now you wait here. Let's talk in the staff room.
I think we should report it straight away.
Not until we've talked. You go ahead, I'll be there in a minute. Satisfied?
With what?
I told you I could protect her and I just proved it.
What if he reports her?
He won't. Now you go ahead and arrange things the way I told you. Before I decide I don't need your help and do it myself.
Great! Did you find anything out?
Can't even on the skip round, kid.
No, it's not yet.
I said it was. And you can go to the toot for a while.
I don't want
to. Go when I say.
Where do you think
out. You are? One word to the freak and I'll stuff the bloody stinking sweatshop in here anyway.
What are you waiting for?
Keep it for a while. It's bad news. The freak's working in with some crims, real heavy types. That's where the drugs are coming from. And if anything happens to the freak, they're gonna kill Bongo and Grub.
Bloody hell!
They mean it too.
God! Well, the freak will have us for breakfast now. Well, what are we going to do?
There's nothing much we can do, except keep out of her way as much as we can. If everything works out all right, it shouldn't be for too long.
You got a plan, eh?
The gang's working on it. They're going to try and get Bongo and Grub out. Once they do that, the freak should be fair game.
Well, how long's that going to take?
Your guess is as good as mine. We'll know when it happens. Until then, we're going to have to cop whatever she dishes out to us.
Yeah, well, I reckon I can do that, you know? I keep thinking about what the conquerors will do to her when they get their hands on her.
The conquerors aren't gonna get their hands on her.
I thought you said that they
were not gonna get the chance. The minute I know that Bongo's in the clear, I'm gonna do what I should have done a long time ago. I'm gonna fix the bitch myself. And this time, nothing's gonna stop me.
Didn't you hear all the yelling?
What yelling?
Over by H Block cell.
No, we've just come down from C Block. What's happened?
Well, I don't know, but it looked like Jones had been roughing Rodder.
Oh, him again.
Has he reported it? I'm not sure.
Oh, well, I better go and investigate, make sure he knows the procedure.
No, don't. He'll report it if he wants to.
It's not a matter of what he wants.
I just don't want him thinking I came running to tell tales to you.
Marty, you have got to stop thinking like this. If someone else mentioned it to me, I'd want to know what happened. Now, if I don't go just because it was you who told me, then it really does look as though I'm giving you special treatment, doesn't it?
Well, I suppose. But I think it's all under control. Joan Ferguson seemed to have pretty much taken charge.
She was there?
She sure was.
Well, if that's the case, I don't suppose there's any need for me to get involved. But I'll be very interested to hear what's happened. Yeah, so will I.
I better get back to my rounds.
Oh, she didn't hurt you, I hope.
Yes, she did. I'll have a hell of a sore neck tomorrow.
Yes, I'm sorry. I should have warned you about Jones. She's usually harmless, but... Well, she's a bit simple and needs to be handled in a particular way.
Well, why is she here? She ought to be put away. I'm going to say as much in my report.
I'd appreciate it if you didn't make one.
She attacked an officer.
Oh, not intentionally. Look, I believe that you and I think the same way. You know, prisoners should be kept in their place, and when they step out of line, you come down on them like a ton of bricks.
Exactly.
But to every rule, there's an exception. And I think you're smart enough to see that.
Well, maybe. What's so special about her?
She's useful. Now, you saw how easily I got her on side. Just basic psychology. Something I think you might be pretty good at.
Well, I've read a few books and I think I've got a certain instinctive ability.
Then you know how easy it is to manipulate people like her. Use her to help control the others. That's why I wouldn't like to see her transferred.
Yes, I can understand that. How would Mrs. Reynolds feel about this?
Oh, to worry about her. I'm the deputy governor. She and I understand each other.
Oh.
Just what are you insinuating, Mr. Adams?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all.
Certainly the governor and I have our areas of disagreement. It's only natural. But only this morning she stressed to me the importance of not coming down too hard on the prisoners. She'd be in full agreement with what I'm asking you.
Oh, I hear we had a small disturbance.
Ah, no disturbance. Just a misunderstanding.
Well, the way I heard it, Jones attacked Officer Adams.
Oh, really? The way people spread stories. No, Jones was just throwing a bit of a tantrum because she couldn't get her own way. I've been explaining to Officer Adams how important it is to treat her with special understanding.
Yes, that's all it was. No hassle.
There you see. Some people just can't wait to stir up trouble. Fortunately, Mr. Adams isn't one of them.
That's all we can do. So don't anyone give the freak an excuse to come down on us.
Since when did she need an excuse?
All right, but we don't have to make it easier for her.
Can't we set her up so she gets sprung bringing the drugs in?
No, she's too smart for that. She's probably just looking the other way when the stuff comes in.
Well, Rita, we have to stop Kath Maxwell and Williams.
All right, we will. Look, if McDermott's crowd thought Ferguson had bailed with it, they'd drop her like a hot brick. Then I could go after the bitch without having to worry about Bongo. Well, let's set him up then. It's risky if something goes wrong.
At least we can let the others know she's working with Maxwell's lot. See how many friends they've got then, eh?
Yeah, well, let them keep going. There's got to be a way we can make what they're doing work for us.
I thought you said you were against drugs.
I am. I mean, we find a way to make it backfire on them. But whatever it is, it's got to be something a freak can't tie us into. At least until Bongo and Grab are clean.
Jeez, why don't you ask for something hard?
There's always a way. It's just going to take a bit of heavy thinking. In the meantime, no one even breathes near the freak without my say-so. You all got that?
Yeah.
Sure. Right. I'll see you later.
Couldn't wait, I see.
Wait for what?
To run and tell Mummy what happened.
Well, why wouldn't I? She likes a good joke as much as anyone.
What joke?
Well, that's what I'd call it. You being thumped around by Jones and having to be rescued by Joan Ferguson.
That's not what happened. If you've got to run telling tales, at least get them right.
Listen, I've had as much as I can
tell
you.
Nothing! Stop that! Now, what's going on?
Nothing.
Don't you give me nothing. Fighting like schoolboys and in the middle of the corridor where a prisoner can walk past at any time. Didn't they teach you anything in training?
Yes, sorry, it was my fault. I started it.
That's the truth. I was minding my own business walking along the corridor.
Oh, I'm sure you were. But you do have the ability to rub everyone up the wrong way, don't you?
That's not my fault, is it?
Well, whoever's fault it is, you can both explain it to the governor. Now get a move on.
It's all right, Merle. Honestly, Miss Ferguson promised me you won't get into any trouble.
I will, but Mr. Ferguson's always telling fibs.
No, you won't. I'm promising you, and I don't tell fibs, do I? Now, how about I read you a story?
Oh, Kath, will ya?
Of course I will. Which one?
Captain Marvelous and the Attack of the Broom People.
Okay.
And it's got horses in it and everything.
Right, here we go. An ordinary day in Metro City. But deep down in his underground laboratory, Professor Dredd is making a terrifying discovery.
I know what it is. He's made a secret formula that brings straw to life.
Well, we'll wait and see, shall we? The professor says, "At last I have succeeded. Soon the whole world will be under my control."
Look what she thinks she's wearing. She was not Mary Poppins gone wrong.
What'd she just say?
Nothing, Merle. We'll just ignore her.
She's making fun of me.
Merle. She's trying to make you angry to get you into trouble.
I don't care. I hate her. I want to get her.
No, we'll forget about her. We'll just read this comic, okay?
Read it, Kath. You gonna read it?
Yeah, in a minute. Merle, I was thinking. Maybe I should have let you get Connors. She deserves it, trying to make you unhappy all the time.
I can get her. There's still time.
No. Not now. Later will be better. In the exercise period.
Oh, you tell me when, Kath. You tell me when I can get her.
I will.
You promise?
Yes, I promise. This time no one will stop you.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun.